Hi, my name is Tiago Duarte and welcome to another video tutorial here at Daily Beats. In today's video, we are going to do a trap beat and I'm going to explain how to make a trap beat. And also, I don't have anything in mind, I want to do a type beat of X and Y. No, I just want to explore FL Studio and see what we can come out with. So before we start the tutorial, I would like to ask you to subscribe and activate the notification so that you know when we upload new videos. And if you like this video, leave a like, and if you have any questions or suggestions, just leave them in the comments below. Also, if you'd like to support this channel, consider going to our website www.dailybeats.pt and buy one of our products, because it helps us a lot to continue to make free videos for YouTube and also Facebook. So let's continue. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a piano. So I'm going to use the packs from FL Studio. Actually, let me think. Let's go here. I was messing around with a sample. And let me see which one was. Not this one. I like this one. So let's open up in SliceX. And so we have this marker here. Let's delete it. Let's go to markers, auto slice, medium, auto slice. And this slices everything like this. So let's bring the pitch a little bit up, like 300 cents. Or even down. Yeah, I like it. I like down. So let's see what can we do here. Let's put 138. Okay, let's repeat this. Okay, let's start at 20. Let's try something like this for this variation here. Okay, I like this, so let's put this on the in the playlist. Okay, I like this drum loop, so let's open up again in SliceX. Let's do the same, delete this marker, auto slice and medium auto slice. Okay, let me grab my snare. Okay, let's apply a fade out because this has a lot of sound here. Okay, I like this. Okay. Okay, again, let's see, the snare goes here, 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 and also let's do something like this. Okay, let's work with hi-hats. I like this rhythm. Let's duplicate it. Okay, now here, what can we do? Okay, let me put something like this to see. Let's lower the volume. I like this, so let's copy it over here and let's copy it here and delete this one here. Okay, and I want to do a hi-hat roll here, so let me go here to 1.5 step and do something like this and do some variation in the volume. Okay, I like this. Now let's grab a kick and an 808. Let's go to dailybeats.pt, drum kits, headbanging trap drums, kit. Okay, I like this one here. Let me try something like this. Okay. Another one here. And another one here and here. Maybe some here also. Okay, I like this. So this is the kick, this is snare, this is piano. Sorry, let me see what can I do here. I want to go ahead and open up gross beat. I want to do some variation here to the piano, and let me see what can we do here. I like this one, but not everywhere. So what I'm going to do is to copy this. Why am I in pattern 5? So whatever, let's be in pattern 5. So this is the piano, this is snare. What I'm going to do is to copy this one over, and we can do with Alt C. And it creates a new copy of the same instrument, and I'm going to put here the hi-hats. Okay, and let's put this on a new channel, hi-hats. Okay, and this is kick, And now what I'm going to do is to separate everything because I want everything separated. And let's go now with the piano. And what I'm going to do is here in the last, in the eighth bar, I'm going to automate this cross speed. So let's see, I want to apply the automation to the solo, to the effect, solo effect, sorry about that. I want to apply the automation to the solo button. So like this, and I want to create a new point here and here like this, and this will only play the automation, the gross speed here in the last part of the piano. So let me separate everything else. Kick, snare, hi-hats, and kick. Okay, let's listen. Let's put everything on channel 1 and call this mix. Let's bring up here the limiter, fruity limiter, so that we can increase the volume of our instrumental. Okay, sounds better. One thing that I like to put is reverb on the piano. A lot of reverb. Same every time. I will have to review that, but for now I will leave it as is, even with this strange effect. So this is the crash. Let's put it here on the mix. Let's apply some parallel reverb. Let's call this aux reverb, and let's put here the waves IRL full stadium. I use this one because I really like the presets, the plate preset, and you can also use Fruity Convolver if you'd like, if you don't have Waves plugin. And let's go here to Fidelity EQ, apply a high pass filter. Okay, sounds nice. Okay, now let's grab an 808. Oh, I like this one. Let's bring it to channel 7. Now, what we want to do is to... This one is in the key of D, so we have to put it on D and apply this type of envelope with a hold selected, because this way I can play a note and when I release, the 808 will stop. Let's go here to the piano. I know CAC is in the key of the sample. One thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to do follow the rhythm of the kick. Okay. I know, I think it's in the C minor key. Okay, I like this pattern. And now let's see here in the final. Okay, so let's go up like this and then go down. Maybe this one here, let's see. And then we are going to bring everything down. Sorry about that, I had a call. So what else can we add here? What I was thinking in adding some kind of strings. So let me open up Orchestral Companion Strings. Okay, and let's go ahead and enable strings. I think this is experience some cracking here in the beat. I don't know why. Okay, so one thing that I experience here, whenever I do this, whenever I delete, or not I delete, but I disable the solo, we hear a pop. Okay, so one way of solving this is to go ahead and select everything and create an automation for the volume also. So let's go ahead here, let's put everything down like so, and let's do some kind of fade in, very subtle, like this, and let's do the same here for the end. Like this, and this hopefully will take out the cracks in the in enabling and disabling the gross beat. At least when disabled it doesn't affect. We still have here whenever we enable it. So what else can I do? Let me bring this down. Strange that it shouldn't be doing this, because this is going up like this. Open up more. So I think this is because of the solo option. So let me disable the automation and let's work only with let's delete everything. Let's work only with the automation from the volume. So let's create a new point here, let's create a new point here, and let's see if this solves the issue. Okay, now I have to enable it. Okay, so what else can I do here? So one thing that happens is that whenever I enable the I created automation here and the not the volume, the solo button was disabled, and that's is going to be the state for the entire track. So I have to go here, delete the automation, and then go here also to my project, current project, patterns, initialize controls, and delete this one. Okay, and oops. Now if I enable it, okay, now it should be, should work without any problem. So like this. Okay. Now let's put the orchestral companion strings here. And let's call this 808. If I can use that kind of effect like this, okay, and let's crank up the volume so that we can have that kind of effect. Okay, now it's too loud. Will be 808, control V, let's select this string pattern, control X, let's call this strings F4, strings, and control V, and now we have everything here. Let's bring the 808. Okay, so now one thing that I like to do is to put these, the drums here at the top. I always do that. I always put my drums at the top. And now let's go ahead and select this. And let's make here some small composition. Okay, so let's do some kind of intro. No drums, only the piano. And also I would like to have this effect here. So what I'm going to do is select everything, put it like this. No, wait, wait, no strings, maybe strings, let's see. No strings, just the piano. And then the strings will come in the chorus, so. Okay, something like this. Just leave the snare. So let's take out the hi-hats and the kick. And let's just leave the bass only to the point at the snare. Okay, I like this. We could also add another effect. So let me go here to bar mode, make a nice selection. Let's add electric piano. Let's go here to expand e-pianos and let's see what we have here. Let's choose. So F4, E-piano, oops, E-piano, let's copy this, and let's go here to the mixer and put the piano here, oops, route to this track only, and let's call this E-piano, let's put this on the playlist, like this, and let's create this. Okay, so I just want them like... Let me make here a chord. So I want to select everything and do some strumming. So Alt S. Okay, I like this, but I want to lower the volume. Maybe let me see if it fits better on the snare. Let me see if I can. Okay. I like this. So let me grab another part of this. Will not work, I think so. Let's listen one more time. Let me see here. Now let me go back here to Rust Beat. Let me delete these points. I just want like this kind of curvature. Let me accentuate. Maybe not that much. Okay, I like this. I think it fits better. also do some kind of break here in the introduction, in this part. But actually, let me see if I have here in Telebeat Stop ET hip hop drum loops. Let's see where are the hip hop drum loops. I think there is some kind of break here. Let me see if I can find it. I thought I had some kind of break, but maybe no. I don't think I will find it like this. Okay, drum loop fill. Let's see if it fits. Okay, so maybe I will have to extend this. So let's go here to audio. No, here to stretch. And let me see. Let me lower the volume. It's not going to be easy because this is not. Okay, so what can I do here? Let me maybe put here in two parts. Let me go like this and let's see. No, it will not work. So at least in this beat, the idea that I had at least. Okay, so let's listen from the beginning. Or not is the techniques that I give you when I make this kind of beats, and it doesn't have to be with the sound of the beat. It has to be with the techniques, the way of making beats that you can take lessons from. Okay guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel and activate the notification so that you know when we upload new videos. And if you have any questions or suggestions, just leave them in the comments below. And if you like to support us, go to our website dailybeats.pt and buy one of our products. It helps us a lot to continue to make free videos here to YouTube and also Facebook. And yeah, I will have links in the description if you want to check them out. Also, I forgot to tell you that if you want this project file with all these files and this beat, I will have a link in the description so that you can subscribe to our membership. It's the exclusive membership, and you will also have the a second video where I mix and master this track. So that's only for premium members and exclusive members. And if you want to see the prices and see the what we have to offer, I will have a link in the description. And that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.